In this section, we're going to go through a list of questions that a nurse or a doctor may ask you. When you enter into a hospital or possibly a doctor's office, you would walk up and say to the receptionist, who a receptionist is the person who receives you, and ask them, "I am here to see Dr. Smith," or "I have an appointment with Dr. Smith." Then the waiting game begins. What I mean by this is you have to wait. Generally, the doctors are not on time. I mean, who can blame them, right? How many people go into the doctors to see a doctor and don't really know what's wrong with them? So just be prepared to wait. Have your phone, a book, whatever you might need. Yet let's take a look at what are some of the questions a nurse or a doctor may ask you as you come into their office. What symptoms do you have? Now, a symptom is something that is leading to something else. In this case, we're talking about a sickness. What symptoms do you have for maybe your stomach ache? Oh, he may ask you, "Have you eaten anything strange in the last 24 hours?" And you might think about it and say, I ate an old hot dog in the refrigerator, which then may have given you stomach pain, which stomach pain is a symptom for food poisoning. Something else is, do you have any idea what may have triggered your symptoms? So the word triggered. Trigger is that little kind of notch on a gun that you pull to shoot the bullet. Because when you pull the trigger, it then causes the bullet to be shot. Now, back to our example of the stomach pain. What triggered the stomach pain? Well, eating the old hot dog in the refrigerator triggered the stomach pain. It means it caused it to hurt. What is the duration of your symptoms? Duration is a length of time. Maybe it's 24 hours, 48 hours, a week, 2 weeks. Just when you enter into, say, a foreign country and someone is looking at your passport, they might ask you, what is your duration of stay? Which just means, how long are you staying? Have you ever been operated on? It's pretty simple, right? Operation is when they cut you open and do some things to you. Were there any complications? So a complication to an operation would mean maybe they cut you open to do surgery on your shoulder. And once they had your shoulder opened up, your heart rate went way down, or your blood pressure began to drop, which then the doctors had to do all sorts of things in order to raise that blood pressure back up. It was a complication to what would seem like a simple surgery on your shoulder. Have you ever had an allergic reaction to any medication? Now, you want to remember this, allergic reaction. What medication are you allergic to? For example, I am allergic to amoxicillin. Amoxicillin is an antibiotic. If I take amoxicillin, my whole body is a rash. A rash is the little red dots that start to show up all over your arms. It gets real itchy. That's a rash. So I have a rash whenever I take amoxicillin, and possibly I could die from it. So the doctors want to know, what are you allergic to? What do you have an allergy? Another question is lifestyle questions. Now, a lifestyle question is how you live your life. They want to know a little bit about what you do in your free time. So a doctor may say, have you ever or do you currently smoke? Smoking, cigarettes, cigars, whatever it might be. How often and how much alcohol do you drink? So maybe say, I have a beer every night, or, I drink a glass of wine with dinner. It's important just to tell the doctor, and he's not going to tell on you if you say, I probably have 20 drinks a week, maybe. I don't know. I can't really remember. I had too many. But regardless, it's important just to let the doctor know, yeah, you do drink. You drink often. Do you or have you ever taken any recreational drugs? And recreational comes from recreation, and recreation means to have fun. What do you do for recreation? Well, for recreation, I play basketball. Maybe I go swimming. Those are some recreational activities. Now, a recreational drug is a drug you use to have fun. So, an example of that is marijuana. You smoke marijuana or weed for fun. It's illegal. So, most people lie about this one and tell the doctor, nah, I don't take recreational drugs. Cocaine, heroin, these are a few recreational drugs. They're all illegal, but it's your choice to tell the doctor or not tell the doctor. For women, they will ask, have you ever been pregnant? And pregnant just means you have had a baby. If you say, yes, I have been pregnant, they may also ask you, did you ever have a miscarriage? Depending on what your problem is. A miscarriage is when the baby dies inside of the mother. So you don't go full term. So you don't actually deliver the child. And a last question they may ask, again, is a lifestyle question. Have you ever had an STD? And they may even ask more of, are you currently sexually active? Which sexually active means, are you having sex? An STD is a sexually transmitted disease. So they want to know, do you have any of these? So that's just a brief list of some of the questions a doctor may ask you as you go in the office. And really, you can be as open and honest as you like. And the more open and honest you are, probably the doctor will be able to help you with whatever problem you're having. Throughout this section, we talked about different symptoms of illnesses. Something you can do now is take some time to think of a situation. If you can't think of a situation, let me give you a few examples. Maybe you're in a car accident. You have the flu. You broke your arm or leg. What words would you use to describe these symptoms? Now, some of you might say, I don't have the vocabulary. I can't do that. Well, you know what it is in your native language, and you can easily look it up in a dictionary, online, and practice trying to say, what is it? What are these symptoms that are happening to you? Because eventually, you may have to describe these symptoms in English.